Hey, welcome back to Happy Little Note Trees. Today we're going to be talking a little bit more about film emulation, particularly the Filmverse DCTL as an option for developing that filmic cinematic look and, you know, doing that thing where you make a little happy note tree and transforming footage. So I got a couple clips from my play around folder for film emulation type stuff. In this video, we're just going to look at Filmverse and as a DCTL and the options that it has. In the next video, or that may be linked there or somewhere else, we'll compare it to like Film Look Creator and Enhancer. So kind of just depends what works best for you. But yeah, Filmverse is, so I have my footage. We'll just start with this guy right here. We just have our footage getting into DaVinci Wide Gamut because that's the working space that it works in. We'll reset that, turn off. So this is just using OpenDRT. You can watch some of the other videos on this channel or other channels about using DRTs versus using this Resolve color management or other options. But yeah, DCTLs, you kind of need that for the studio version, but a lot of really cool things to make some fun images. And so all these clips are using OpenDRT as a normal way to get from DaVinci Wide Gamut back to Rec 709. And it's just a DCL drop-in, so you can find it in your thing, and you turn it on, and instantly it is going to compress and rearrange the pixels on your thing. But it's really nice. It's got a really clean interface. Right now it's set. Its default is to be Kodak Vision 500T, which is a low grain option. And then I have it set to print to Kodak 2383, the D65 white point. So from what I understand, they did their modeling a little bit more classically in terms of doing scans and then trying to match DaVinci Wide Gamut with a matrix to match. You can read more about it at Colorist Foundry. But yeah, a lot of fun settings to play with in terms of making the look that you want to make. Making slight adjustments here and there. Instantly kind of reshape it. And so that is one of the things that I find interesting with how we talk about film emulations is because you end up with this situation where as you're tweaking these settings, like what is the true north of the capture stock to the print stock? And honestly, the more I've done film emulation looks, the more I kind of come out of this gravy boat of thinking that it doesn't really matter as much as you think. It's kind of more like trying to get to what is it about the film stock that you like and the colors that are presented, because what it was captured on is a negative, maybe very different. Like it isn't just like, oh, let's do a 2383 LUT, because what it was captured on might be completely different than what it was originally printed to and things like that. So I'm just kind of playing around with the different sliders of input mid-gray, kind of just changes its exposure value. Skin hue is probably just a place to protect your skin. This is a roll-off on the high end, so a trim. And then this is how the shadows roll off, and it's pretty much just affecting the black point. And so the white point and the black point, I haven't really figured out where to put this in my note tree as much. But what I do like about it compared to, say, Enhancer or Film Look Creator is it's a simple set of tools. It's not crazy. You can see I'm just sliding things around here. It's a simple set of tools that it just walks through what you want to do, where you want to do it. And it is, to a degree, quite controlled. So ultimately, like, it comes in pretty quick and easy. Whereas if you were to look at Dehancer, which we'll do in the next video, it is quite simple in terms of how it gets to where it wants to get. So if you want to stick around, the next video should be popping up right here. Otherwise, like, subscribe, do all those YouTube things. There's a link in the description to learn more about this DCTL. I am not sponsored by it in any way, so I just asked if I wanted to take a look-see-poo at it. So, and compare it to the work that I'm doing on my own film emulation, as well as stuff I've done about Dehancer and things like that. So, yeah. What is True North in a film emulation? The hard part is, it's hard to see. I guess we could do, let's just see. Let's just drop a DCTL in here. Just kind of see what it is doing. Yeah. Spherical. Do I have this set up the way? There we go. Oops, saturation, that's why I turned it off. Alright, so if we have our main six hues plus a gray ramp, we can kind of see what it's doing when you play around with it. So if we refresh it, you can see kind of specific to the colors what different sliders are doing. But this is what this is what just OpenDRT is doing, and then what it's doing under OpenDRT. They say on their website that they're possibly working towards making their own DRT, which probably would make sense in terms of having control, like when you have whatever you're feeding into a DRT is going to reshape and rebend how things curve. So you can see on the scopes how things are happening as you move the sliders around. I haven't really played around with skin. That's kind of how it's hitting that red. Then that split tone is what I was really interested in. So if we neutralize everything and just look at that split. The split curve mix is not really as controlled as I would like. It either just puts green in the highlights or warmth in the highlights, but I don't see much effect in the shadows that is separate. So, yeah. It is free to play around. This chips pattern is also a DCTL download. If I remember when I'm uploading this video, I will put a link in the description. But yeah, one thing that it's, I'm not sure I like yet is, what I do like is, I am bad. We can see where it's breaking the high end at that purity level. And yeah, it's one of those things that's hard to say what. Let's zoom in on our scopes. You can see this is just what it's doing. So our colors are straight lines. It's got a little chink up on the one side. As I'm looking at my vector scope. And that's it's now. I did do twisty bits. That's its natural, how it's affecting it from turning it from straight lines to that. If you look at the vector scope. But yeah, if you even stuck this far, you better stick around for the next one. When we look at this versus Film Look Creator versus everything else, that video should be up here by now as a place to watch. But until next time, have a happy little node tree.